Fox News alert on bombshell new claims about the border crisis as the New York Post reports the White House is secretly flying planes packed with underage migrants across the country, jetting them from Texas to New York in the cover of night. All this leading critics to wonder why the Biden administration would need this kind of covert operation if it had nothing to hide. This is Outnumbered. I'm Emily Campagno. I'm joined by my co-host Harris Faulkner and Kaylee McEnany, Fox News Headlines 24/7 reporter Carly Shimkus, and in the center virtual seat, Fox and Friends Enterprise reporter Lawrence Jones. Now, the charter flights from Texas reportedly underway since August, with some of the planes touching down in Florida and dropping off dozens of migrants there before heading to New York to resettle the others, busing them to nearby locations. This comes as leaked documents detail the staggering catch and release numbers under the Biden administration, showing that since the beginning of August, tens of thousands of migrants have been released into the U.S. with little or no oversight. All this as we, as usual, still await the official border numbers from last month. And Senator Ted Cruz says it's clear the president's policies are responsible for the border crisis.
Well, their entire political strategy is based on secrecy. What is happening at our southern border is an absolute tragedy. We've had over 1.3 million people cross illegally. We're on a path to have over 2 million people cross. And Joe Biden and Kamala Harris caused this, and their entire strategy is ignore it, and they're counting on the corrupt corporate media to ignore it as well. So of course they fly in the middle of the night because they have no defense.
Lawrence, you recently came back from the Texas border. Now, was it common knowledge down there where the migrants were being flown to?
They knew they were going on planes, but they didn't know exactly the origin, the destination that they were heading to. So our people on the ground have long suspected this. Look, as someone that was just there embedded with the Texas Special Operations Unit, they're really the ones that are on the front of lines of this fight. You know, the Border Patrol aren't allowed to do their job, so Texas is doing the arrest and then handing them over to Border Patrol. The big question is, why should the American people care about this issue? Of course, there are laws being broken, but I think the larger conversation is the cartel. This is all a part of the criminal enterprise that the cartel now feel emboldened. They just fired off two shots last week at our National Guard. The same pathway that they use to have people pay to play to get across the border is the same way that the drugs are trafficked and human trafficking is going through as well. And right now, the reason why they feel like they can get away with this is because the Biden administration, behind the scenes, will admit to Border Patrol in Texas that there is a crisis, but when they get in front of the cameras, they say something much different. In Panama right now, there are 30,000 migrants waiting to cross the border, and Texas DPS estimate that they'll cross back to the Del Rio sector or the RGV sector within 3 weeks. So obviously the Biden administration hasn't learned from the Haitian crisis that happened a few weeks ago. They were warned back in June and did nothing. This is part two. And if you wonder why Democrat seats that are on the local area of Texas are flipping to Republican, this is the reason. Because it's not a political thing for them. It is about safety. I interviewed a guy crossing the border last week, and when the DPS was processing him, I said, you know, what is, did you get a record? He said that he was deported under Donald Trump. He said, look, the former president just deported me because of my driver's license. We ran his background. He was wanted in three states, had domestic violence abuse charges as well, and told me that he was going to go see his next wife. So that's what we're dealing with. Am I saying that all the folks that are crossing the border are criminals? No, but we don't know all the people that are crossing. And I think Americans are frustrated with this issue, as well as Democrats as well.
Oh, that's exactly right. So, Carly, let's break this down for a second, top to bottom. So our president is using secret flights to small airports to move unaccompanied illegal migrants, children, right? Yeah. And the reason that he's doing it in secret, one can presume, is so that no one knows about it. And to Lawrence's point, you know, who does know about it are the people in Central and South America. And that's why they are paying smugglers to take their children on this perilous journey north to get onto these planes and then be distributed everywhere. And we are waiting for the border numbers, the border encounter numbers, like I mentioned earlier, but the numbers that we do have, the amount of encounters between Border Patrol and unaccompanied migrant children are enough to fill Madison Square Garden every month in succession, Carly.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and you know, the situation with the flights, I guess shouldn't come as a surprise because the Biden administration did this in May. They were sending flights filled with migrant children, but in the middle of the night, and those flights were landing in Tennessee. And I think what's happening is the Biden administration is really caught off guard with how unpopular their immigration policies are. And I say that they're caught off guard because, and I guess to President Biden's credit, he told the American people that he was going to do this. I mean, he ran on the platform of reversing President Trump's policies on immigration. And during the Democratic debate, when he was asked if his health care plan would provide coverage for illegal immigrants, his hand shot up along with everybody else. So the American people knew what they were getting when they voted for him. And now they see what it looks like and they don't like it. And a lot of even Democrats, because his poll numbers are 23% approval on immigration and border issues, that means that a lot of Democrats are missing President Trump's policies, which is wild because he was vilified for those policies. Mm-hmm. The last thing I'll say on this is that this is really the first time that our country has had an open border. I mean, even President Obama, he was labeled the deporter in chief. And all it takes is one horrific situation where a Border Patrol agent, God forbid, gets shot, or there's another, God forbid, Kate Steinle situation. And the Biden administration is really going to have to face what they've created.
Yes, and Harris, you know, we talked earlier about the catch and release aspect to this as well. The former Border Patrol Chief Rodney Scott, who served under the Biden administration, he told Fox, he says, this administration is abusing the system. He said, when I was sector chief, we granted 5 to 10 paroles a year. He said the Biden administration has granted 32,000 in 2 months.
Yeah, so the main question is why? Right? That's the main question. I don't know that Jen Psaki is going to approach that answer. We can't approach Biden or Kamala Harris. So if there's no approaching and no answers and no, and because we know we got plenty of questions, I don't know how you find out why. And if you don't know the why, you can't stop it. Like you've got to know, what does she like to say, the vice president? The root causes of their decision making. I want to get to something you mentioned though, and because you asked Lawrence such a good question, do the people know where they're going? I want to give you one day's flight plan by Eric Sean earlier. 6:37 a.m. McAllen, Texas to Villahermosa, Mexico. Round trip, 9:17 back from Villahermosa to McAllen, Texas. 7:47, McAllen, Texas to El Paso, Texas. 2:04 p.m., El Paso, Texas to Jacksonville, Florida. Remember, some of the kids are being taken to a detention center outside Tallahassee. 7 p.m., they're still flying.
Yeah.
They've been flying since 6:37 in the morning. Jacksonville, Florida to Westchester, New York, outside of New York City. These planes are busy. And I think the tragedy that Carly was kind of, you know, it's unfortunate. We hope nothing happens, particularly with the grown-ups, but with the children, we don't know because it's all happening at night. There's no accountability for unaccompanied minors. And you know what? You can preach all day long about how that shouldn't happen. Why are they doing this? Why are they doing this at night? What are they hiding? What don't they want us to know? Because you do shady stuff in the shade.
And it's basically like a constellation, like a subway station every hour on the hour, but going all across the country. And Kaylee, this administration, what this scene is that we're depicting is a whole lot different than when candidate Biden promised us.
Oh yeah, remember, this is the most transparent and humanitarian administration in history. Joe Biden, his literal quote was he promised us the highest standard of transparency. Jen Psaki stood at the podium and said, I will share the truth even when it's hard to hear. Well, I've been watching some of the press briefings. I don't recall her standing from the podium and saying we're doing secret flights at night from Westchester to Jacksonville, dumping more than 100,000 migrants in the country. I didn't hear that at the podium. No, the truth wasn't shared with us. It is hard to hear, and the truth was concealed. And what is concealed, by the way, on the humanitarian level? Remember, Kamala's our big humanitarian. Kids being dumped over border walls and left on their own. Girls in emergency intake facilities using the restroom in bags. Kids on suicide watch lists and facilities that reporters aren't able to go into. No. This is what's being concealed from the great humanitarians, the Bidens and Kamala Harris.
And most of that you're talking about is happening in the daytime.
Yeah.
And we still can't see. Right? I have a quick legal question for you.
Yes,
and,
ma'am.
And I know it's your segment, but I got to pick your brain on this. So do municipalities, like I live in New Jersey, they're taking some of these children there in the cover of night. And that is the problem, by the way. It's not the beautiful little precious ones. It is the route that they're coming. And as General Keane said, they're institutionalizing illegal immigration into this country. And they're starting young, right? Do these municipalities, these states, have to face any sort of recourse from their citizens who balk at this night flight situation?
Well, this was the subject in part of the lawsuit from the governors against the federal government. So I think the better link is the citizens to the federal government who is imposing this on the municipalities and the states, right? Mm. Because technically, through the Supremacy Clause, the federal government does trump any type of local and state laws, but only when it's constitutional. And so that's what these governors are arguing. They're saying you are encroaching on states' rights.
DeSantis.
Exactly, among right. others. They're saying you're encroaching on our states' rights. You are depleting our resources, and what you're doing is unconstitutional. So they have taken up that mantle, that argument on behalf of their citizens, saying you're leaving us with nothing, and you're just dumping all of these likely COVID positive and the like migrants and unaccompanied minors. But I look forward to seeing the future lawsuits as well about these kids.
Hi, everyone. I'm Brian Kilmeade. I want you to do me a favor. I want you to click to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page. This is the only way that I know for sure that you're not going to miss any great commentary, any great news bites, any great interviews coming your way on Fox. You can get it all here on YouTube. So subscribe right now.